What is up, guys? Jimmy or Chaos? People always ask me, what are you saying in your intro? Because I say it so fast. I am saying, what is up, guys? Jimmy or Chaos here. So you can call me by my real name, Jimmy, or by my my YouTube persona, Chaos. And welcome back. What's up, guys? Jimmy or Chaos here. Welcome back. Yeah, that is what I'm saying. Today, we are going to talk about Black Ops 4. And before you say, what are you doing, Jimmy? We're not even to Call of Duty World War II yet. Why are you worried about Call of Duty 2018? Just bear with me, okay? Bear with me. And I have deemed today National Control Freak Day. I don't know why, but yeah, I'm sponsored by it. Make sure you guys use promo code ChaosXSilencer, not Chaos. I couldn't grab Chaos for some reason. Somebody else snatched it. But if you get anything Control Freak, make sure you tweet at me and let me know you did. Link is in the description. Now, we're going to talk about Black Ops 4, but before we get into that, so many of you want beta codes for Call of Duty World War II, and I know it is the biggest beta for Call of Duty probably ever. I fully understand that, and the fact that it's a private invite and you have to pre-order and all that stuff, I get it. I've given out like probably 30 so far, and I told you guys in the last video I did it, that was going to be it. I didn't have any more. I got 10 more. Okay, so it's really simple. Drop a like on the video. Leave a comment why you're excited for the beta. What platform are you going to be playing on? And include your Twitter handle. That is the most important part. I just tweeted out winners from the last video, and you have to have a Twitter handle. That is how I get hold of you. That is how I give you your beta code. So if you win, you redeem it on CallOfDuty.com, and then you pick your platform. I have 10 more, and that's probably going to be it. I know I said that last time, but we'll see. I know so many people want it, so let's do it again. I'll pick 10 winners in a day or two, and you guys will get in the beta. Now, let's talk about Black Ops 4, and the first thing you're going to say, Call of Duty World War II is not here. Why are you talking about Black Ops 4? And it's probably not going to happen. Well, it is Saturday. I already went over all the Call of Duty World War II news the other day, and I wanted to talk about this because I have some thoughts on it. I've been thinking, and my mindset has changed a little bit. So first, let's argue it from both sides, okay? The one side, we don't want Black Ops 4. 1, 2, and 3 was enough. There comes a point where you have to let something great end, okay? I get that. Same if you're a fan of Game of Thrones. It ends next season. Season 8 is it. It's done, and all good things must come to an end, or you just beat them into the ground. So on that side of the argument, I totally get it. Black Ops 1, 2, and 3 were phenomenal. Treyarch did good. Let's end it. I understand that. It'd be too risky to go for a fourth. Once you're in the fourth in the movie world, it's probably pretty crappy usually, okay? So that is that side of the argument, all right? Now, let's go to the other side of the argument, and let's look at how deep the Black Ops storyline is. From the zombie side to the campaign side. We're gonna stick with campaign side because we're not really zombie guys here. You guys are, I'm not, but okay. It is probably the richest, deepest storyline. Now, the Modern Warfare storyline with Soap and Price and Ghost is really deep, okay? But I think it's safe to say, and I think most of you would probably agree with me, that the Black Ops storyline is way deeper. It's way more complex. It spans multiple eras. I mean, let's just break it down for a second, okay? Let's break this down. Black Ops 1 spanned all the way from 1945, after World War I, I believe, somewhere in there, all the way to 1970. In the Cold War, the Vietnam War, I mean, it was crazy. It was crazy. You're going back and forth, back and forth. Then we go to Black Ops 2, we go to like 2025, but we also go back in time again. So we're spanning multiple generations in that one. Then we go to, what was next? Oh, Black Ops 3. And we go like 20 or 40 years, we go to like 2065. So Black Ops has spanned from the 1940s all the way to 2065. That's crazy. Over a century is that storyline. And if you are arguing the fact that you think Treyarch could do a Black Ops 4, you would say there is so much in there that we haven't touched. Right? I mean, there really is. And it's safe to say that Black Ops 1, 2, and 3 were all hits. Black Ops 3 is 2 years old. The game's the most popular Call of Duty right now, okay? So to say Black Ops 4 would be too much, I get it. But then again, I don't necessarily agree with it. Now, I know people argue the fact, hey, we're going boots on the ground, Jimmy, so we can't go to Black Ops 4, because when you think initially Black Ops 4, you think the future. But hang on, it doesn't have to be that way, and you don't have to think inside the box or have tunnel vision. There are so many eras that we could go to. I'm looking at a list right here, and these are things that we could do boots on the ground wise in Black Ops 4. You got the Cold War win all the way into the 80s. We've already experienced a little bit of it in Black Ops 1, the invasion of Panama, the Gulf War, the Bosnian War, the war in Afghanistan, the war in Iraq. All of those would be boots on the ground conflicts that Black Ops 4 could do. I know when you go forward, like 2, 3, and 4, usually it's into the future and then maybe you have flashbacks. That's what people automatically assume. It does not have to be that way, people. We could literally pick up anywhere in this storyline with characters we've already had right in the middle of it. It could happen. It is a viable option that could happen. Now, does it? I don't know. I could see Activision and Treyarch sitting down at the big power table and saying, let's talk about this, boys. Vonderhaar, what do you think? Well, Black Ops is popular, okay? It's an IP that is locked in and the fans love it. But I don't know, 4 may be a little spammy. I think maybe it's time to do something new and innovate. Sledgehammer went from exosuits over to World War II. Should we go back? Everybody is expecting us to do, or Treyarch to do, maybe World at War II. Or World War II, or World War I, whatever, something in that era, but that doesn't have to be the case. They could expand on Vietnam, we could go into modern era and they could do their rendition of modern warfare in Afghanistan, Iraq. There's so many options they could do, and they could label it Black Ops 4. So the question is, the power question of the day, and I want your answer in the comment section, is whatever they do you think it would be smart to label it Black Ops 4? And continue along the history and the timeline and the canon of Black Ops? Or do you think it should be something brand new? I want to know. If you want Black Ops 4 or some connection to it, drop a like on this video and let me know. And I just thought it would be fun to talk about, to speculate, because it's coming. I know we don't have Call of Duty World War II, but guess what? 4 months after we have that, we get into March, we're going to be thinking, well, what in the world is Treyarch cooking up? What's coming next? And that's just how Call of Duty fans are. So yes, I am stoked for Call of Duty World War II. I am ready for this beta. I am ready for everything they are going to bring me. I've not been this excited for a Call of Duty launch probably since, I would say Black Ops 3, but no, I'm going to go back. I'm going to go probably Black Ops 2. I was excited for Black Ops 3, but I was probably most excited when we found out everything about Black Ops 2. So it's been a long time since I've been this ready and amped to get my hands on a Call of Duty and play it. But in the near distant future is the next one, and then the next one. And we don't even want to get talking about what Infinity Ward is cooking up. Oh my God. Treyarch's got it made, okay? There's a movie called, it's a bowling movie, Kingpin. And the guy says, you've got it going for you, man. You're on a gravy train with biscuit wheels. And that's Treyarch, okay? Treyarch can put out, I mean, they have to put out something quality, but fans love them, okay? The Zombie Chronicles was amazing. I mean, Black Ops 3, they're still supporting. So Treyarch can really do no wrong, all right? They haven't fell from graces. Sledgehammer, yeah, they did. They did Advanced Warfare, and they tried to innovate. A lot of people didn't like it, but now they are the savior at the moment of Call of Duty. So Sledgehammer's safe. Infinity Ward, woo! I feel bad for them. I don't know where they go. Because they're on that cusp. They're on that wrong rotation. Because what could be popular right now may not be popular in 2.5 years, and then they're stuck with it, which is exactly what happened to Infinite Warfare. And you can't really blame that part of it on them. The game and not being done and all that, that's a different story. But the fact that they're kind of on that fence of trying to guess what we are gonna want in 2.5 years, that sucks. I mean, that sucks. So let me know what you guys think. Let's talk some Black Ops 4, the potential of COD 2018. Remember, it's National Control Freak Day. Use promo code ChaosXSilencer, link in the description. And if you want to win a beta code, leave a comment which platform you're going to play it on, why you want it. Of course, I know why you want it. And your Twitter handle, and I'll pick those in a couple days. I hope you guys have a fantastic day. I'll be back tonight for another Gaming Top 10. And then if you stick around all night, I'll be back at midnight for a late night squad non-gaming something. talk to you guys.